Well, it is an extremely unfortunate incident, and this indicates two things. Firstly, it shows that religious extremism is spreading in Pakistan, and there are groups who are prepared to kill all those people who dissent with their point of view. So it's an unfortunate situation. The second is that the government of Pakistan is unable to provide adequate security to its senior officials. The governor was killed in Islamabad, and now we have a federal minister who was in the focus because of his views on this issue. Therefore, it's also a failure on the part of the government to address its primary responsibility towards its citizens.
Right. Now, Mr. Askari, do you think, in your opinion, that any sort of connection, to say the least, can be drawn between the murder of the former Punjab Governor Salman Taseer and the now the Minister for Minority Shahbaz Bhatti, considering that a TTP pamphlet was also found from the Ambo site? What it contains is still is yet to be confirmed. However, do you think some was drawn on these two accounts?
Well, it appears, or at least it is very apparent from the information that has reached us, that there must be some extremist religious groups involved in it, because Mr. Shahbaz Bhatti was known for his views on the blasphemy law, and he was expressing his views from time to time. And the method that has been used obviously shows that there were trained people, and that's how these extremist groups have been operating. This is a matter of state concern. This brings not only negative reflection on Pakistan, but also on Islam, that people in the name of Islam can indulge in these kind of activities. Therefore, such an action should be condemned, and both government as well as the society as a whole must think how to deal with this kind of situation when incidents are taking place in the capital city of Pakistan.
Exactly, Mr. Askari, that's exactly what I was going to ask you. One, both important government officials gunned down in the federal capital itself. If the federal capital is not safe, what can we say about the rest of the cities? And they're both very important senior government officials. If they haven't been provided the security, and if that security is not adequate for them even, what would happen to ordinary citizens like us?
This is true. That's the conclusion that everybody would derive from these two incident. It undermines the credibility of the government. It also shows that government is apparently helpless in dealing with the situation. Mm. Therefore, there is a need that the whole security arrangements have to be reconsidered, and the government has to see to it who are the people, who are the groups involved in these kind of activities. The time has come when one has to think about these things with a clarity of mind and evolve strategies. But government alone will not be able to control situation. The society must also address that if intolerance reaches that level, and if intolerance persists, what will happen to Pakistani society as a whole?
Absolutely, Mr. Askari, a rethinking of strategy is necessary. The government is trying to increase security across all cities. We've seen an additional deployment of police personnel in most cities of Pakistan, 9,000 police personnel deployed in Islamabad. Yet, we also see that we know that there is a specific presence of banned militant groups, especially in the south of Punjab. What would be the point of this additional security deployment if those groups themselves are not being targeted, if they are not being weeded out?
I think that appears to be a major problem, that previously these kind of elements used to come from the tribal areas, but now the information suggests that these kind of elements are present in the province of Punjab, and they roam around freely. They take cover of different organizations. No matter whether a person is Muslim or non-Muslim, they are going to target these kind of people.
Mr. Askari, I'm just going to take you back to my earlier question. We know that in the previous Punjab budget, the Punjab government had allocated some 80 million rupees for the Jamaat-ul-Dawa, which we all know is a front for the banned organization, Lashkar-e-Tayyiba. When we see these kind of things happening, do we think the Punjab government itself is turning a blind eye to these kind of things, or are they not aiding it, but just not doing anything about it either?
Well, it appears that various sections of the government have a soft attitude and soft disposition towards militant groups, and that's what we have seen in the case of the Punjab government, but also even within the federal government. We find this sympathy for militancy at the lower levels of the administration, and that is what has to be dealt with. In Punjab, we have enough evidence that these groups have a lot of freedom, and the Punjab government often ignores that. Mm-hmm. It is time that we should deal with this situation in both ways. Firstly, you need to talk to people and also use a state apparatus to control these people. Both methods, talks, negotiations, as well as coercion, have to be used to deal with the situation. Mm-hmm.
Also, Mr. Askari, now talking about this TTP pamphlet that has been found from the Ambu side, that seems to be very surprising, and seems to be a new strategy in which the TTP, if they do claim responsibility and if they do have a hand in this, are trying to send out some sort of message as to why they are doing such heinous crimes. What do you think could we expect in the future with regard to such more incidents coming up, and also as far as the political atmosphere now in the country? How do you see that piling up?
Well, the message is absolutely clear that those people who disagree publicly with their perspective, the perspective of the extremist groups, are in danger. And this also shows that the government lacks the capacity, whether you are talking of the provincial government or of the federal government, to provide security to high-profile people, not to speak of ordinary people. And the message is also very clear to the society as a whole, what kind of values and principles Pakistan stands for. If Pakistan was created for this kind of situation, then one feels that perhaps we are actually violating the principles for which this state was created. Therefore, the very idea of Pakistan, the very notion of Pakistan as a state, is threatened by these incidents. Therefore, everybody has to give a very serious thought to what has been happening in Pakistan, why we are drifting towards extremism. No society can function if these kind of tendencies continue.
Mr. Askari, now the former Punjab governor Salman Taseer, he was assassinated specifically because of his views on the blasphemy laws, because he was supporting Asia Bibi and trying to get her sentence pardoned. And we know that the Minister for Minorities, Shahbaz Bhatti, he was also very vocal about the blasphemy law. Do you think the law needs to be revisited, if not entirely repealed? Do you think extremist elements are taking advantage of this law or using it to further their own gains or basically just misusing it?
Well, I think the whole issue has to be revisited. For the problem is the issue of extremism. For the immediate need, these kind of groups have to be tackled, and the government has to make sure that these groups do not repeat these kind of incidents. Once you have dealt with that, then you can deal with other issues. For the time being, security is important. For the time being, you need to restore the confidence of the people in the capacity of the state to protect its citizens. Mm. And that kind of confidence is badly shaken from today's incident. People thought that perhaps after the governor of Punjab's incident, the government would be very careful. Government would be providing security to Bhatti, because he was outspoken in his views. But today we know that government has utterly failed.
Mr. Askari, my last question to you is, now that we've seen this another brutal murder of another high-profile government official, what do you think could we expect from the minorities of Pakistan, considering that somebody who was representing them in the National Assembly has been gunned down so brutally. What sort of message do you think that has been sent to them? And now, do you think, how do you think they will actually react in such a situation?
Well, the religious minorities in Pakistan were already under pressure, and this incident increases their insecurity. They need to be reassured that Pakistani state would help them, provide them protection, and the responsibility falls primarily on the government of Pakistan to address their insecurities. Then the members, societal member of the majority communities should also come forward to condemn this incident, to assure that society as a whole treats all citizens of Pakistan as equal. Security of all citizens of Pakistan, irrespective of religion, is the primary responsibility of state as well as